I love it when you, like, before they turn the camera on, the floor manager goes 5, 4, 3, and then they don't say 2 or 1 because in TV they don't say 2 or 1 in case someone launches a rocket or something. They go 5, 4, 3, 2. There's always one person in the audience that goes, but only one. And I wonder if it's the same person time after time. Anyway, look, I know you're probably, you know, sitting there getting ready saying, come on, Craig, where's the annual Pancake Tuesday monologue? Is that going to be happening tonight? Well, no, because today, this year, Pancake Tuesday has fallen on National Pig Day. So I had to make a decision, and I felt that I had done so many monologues on Pancake Tuesday that I was going to talk about pigs tonight. So tonight's all about... I just heard it was Pancake Tuesday, and I got the pig thing ready. We'll get through it together. Maybe we'll have bacon on our pancakes. Do I look kind of... am I doing a lot of facey expressions tonight? I'll tell you why. I went to the dentist today, and my teeth are very sensitive, and every time I breathe in, it's agony. If I breathe in through my mouth, it's like, oh, like, I have to go like this, oh. I'm like a lot of Scottish women that I knew back in the day. Maybe that's what's wrong with all the women I was dating. It wasn't me they hated, they just had sensitive teeth. Every time I said it, they'd go, oh. No, I think it was me they hated. Anyway, my teeth are sore, very sore. And yeah. There's nothing really I can do with that. I've kind of used up the old painkiller route.
Cocaine?
I didn't use it as a painkiller, no. Anyway, that was a long time ago. I mean, it's years and years since I had any of that stuff. You'd think I'd get a day off, but apparently not. So, so my teeth are sore tonight. So please, don't send in any boiled sweets this evening. Normally, of course, the studio is awash with them, but with them tonight. Anyway, join us, why don't you, in a minute, when we'll really talk about pigs.
The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Progressive. Visit progressive.com today.
Sit down, relax. I know you're all excited because it's Justin Bieber's birthday, but that's... It is, isn't it? Well, hooray. That's a happy birthday, Justin Bieber. He's 17, but he's Canadian, so he's like... In Canadian years, that's like 40. Hey, guess what? What? I'll tell you, really? Might do. Great day for America, everybody. It is a great day for America. A great day for a great American institution, Kmart. The very first Kmart opened in this day in 1962. Happy birthday, Kmart. And as always, thank you for the awesome suits. It was not a great day for Christina Aguilera, who was arrested for public intoxication. I didn't know that was a crime. Is that a crime? You're drunk in public? Man, I'm surprised I'm not still in jail. Anyway, police said that she didn't resist arrest, but they were very impressed with how well she could hit the high vomit. You know, the... Apparently, Christina was incoherent and stumbling, which makes her the front-runner to host next year's Oscars. Ha! That's right! I haven't let it go! 3 hours of my damn life I watched that! I'm not over it yet! Look, if you watch this show tonight, I admit it'll probably be crap, but it's 1 hour of crap! 1 hour! 1 hour of free crap! Not 3 hours I'd like to thank! I'm not gonna thank anybody, and it's still gonna be crap! Anyway, do you know, I'll get on. Do you know that Anne Hathaway says, she was paid $750,000 to wear that Tiffany diamond necklace at the Oscars. And then, to wear it, they give her the money to wear it. When reached for comment, Lindsay Lohan's like, you can do that? $750,000 of $1 million to wear a necklace. I'd wear it for nothing. I'd wear nothing for three. I'll take my pants off for a damn dollar. Right now. That's a CBS dollar. That doesn't have... Wise ass. Anyway, look, there's a lot going on today. A lot of things going around the world. Unrest in the Middle East and North Africa. There's a lot of strife with the public workers. Financial crisis in Washington. But never mind, because it's National Pig Day. Yes, it's true. It is. It's today. And finally, it's here. It's a real day. It's the day we celebrate an animal that's intelligent, adorable, and most of all, delicious. I look forward to your letters. Your letters from vegetarians. I look forward to your smug, joyless, tofu-stained letters. Your letters written in beet juice. We got a graphic for National Pig Day. Do we have one? Oh, yeah, you go. Oh, yeah. Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences. Anyway, tonight's show is going to be porktacular. We're going the whole hog. We're going to be getting piggy with it. It'll be unbe-squealable. It's going to be... All right, look, the pig-related humor actually caused me some inner turmoil. Now, this is true. I've been doing this show for 6 years now, and the only one joke I regret telling was about a pig, specifically George Clooney's pig. No, it was awful. He had a pet pig who passed away, and he was very sad, and because I'm some vulgar late-night douche, I made a joke about it, and I wish I hadn't done it. I'm ashamed, and I'll never repeat the joke, which went like this. Pig... was I said that his pig had died, and he had this pig and it died, and he'd had the pig for 18 years, and then I said, well, of course, tonight after a touching memorial service, everyone's going to Clooney's house for bacon sandwiches, and I'm not proud. It's just a rotten thing to do, isn't it? Because it wasn't just his pig, it was his pet, it was his friend, his cute little friend. Did we have a picture of George Clooney's cute little friend? There you are. His other cute little friend, and he's fine. He's doing fine. He's also delicious. Let me see him again. There you go. I like pigs. Some people keep their money in a piggy bank. Not me. I'd be always tempted to break it. That's why I keep my money in a real pig. Because you're not tempted to go in after it. You know, it's like, I don't have enough money for it. Well, there's money in the pig. Ah, it doesn't matter. I'll let it go. And there's been great pig movies, the Babe the Pig movie, That'll Do Pig, that was good. Porky the Pig, John Hamm.
Ooh, canned ham, that'd be nice. I made myself laugh, that's a start. Pigs do well in Hollywood, though, because their flat noses make it easy for them to snort cocaine. A normal nose, a human nose, isn't useful for snorting cocaine? Because I can tell you it can be done. Porky Pig, he was the only pig with a speech impediment. He was a that's all, folks. You know what that pig needs? A speech therapist. Perhaps an eccentric Australian speech therapist who could inspire him and teach him to find his inner voice. And then that pig could defeat the Nazis. That's all, Hitler. Because of the movie, when the movie, the guy is this, and then he won the Oscar. Which brings me full circle. It's commercial break time.
Without ads, we're just two dudes in a basement.
I got news for you. Even with the ads, we're still two dudes in a basement. And one of us ain't a dude. One of us is an appliance.
Love it.
Love what?
Snooky.
I don't think so. No. Love what? You love Snooky? Why do you love Snooky?
Balls.
Ah. All roads lead to balls with you, don't they?
Balls.
All right, we'll take a break. When we come back,
lesbians.
You gave it away! When we come back, lesbians. Just get something straight before we go any further. Earlier on, at the very beginning of the show, I mentioned something called boiled sweets. And then later on, Michael, who's the gentleman that sits over there, said, well, look at my collar. Oh, for God's sake. Isn't there a team of people here to tell me when my collar's sticking? You know what the hell? Actually, I kind of like it. I'm like a cop from a 70s detective TV show. Yeah, well, you're going downtown to have some boiled sweets. What the hell are boiled sweets? Ah, I see you didn't grow up in Scotland. Boiled sweets is a way that Scottish people say hard candy. And that's what you're looking at. Hard time. Which some people call candy. Who calls time candy? Time traveling sweet shop owners. Hey, knock it off. I'm in a lot of pain, all right? Time is it, Jeffrey Peterson?
The dingo ate my tweet mail.
God. It's the worst Australian accent I've ever heard. Except for my own, of course. All right, play the tweeties.
Twitter is the thing with all the tweets. You and your friends stay in touch, but never meet. So now the time has come to check the tweets.
And your email, hey, partner, Ashmode.
All right, this is from Dale in Adelaide, Australia. Dale says, Dear Craig, I'm about to move from one city in Australia to another 800 miles away. Do I have to see all my current friends before I go, or should I just leave without telling them? Better than that, what you do is you go down to the beach there in Adelaide and leave a little pile of your clothes.
CBS cares.
Craig, are you encouraging an Australian to fake his own death? Hey, we're... Do I get into trouble for anything legal in Australia? No. I mean, I'm outside the law in Australia. I mean, here in America, if I encourage someone to fake their own death, there'd be all sorts of legal ramifications. But in Australia, do it, you
Rocky Dingo.
Like.
CBS cares.
I'm sorry, I'm not encouraging Australians to fake your own death, but get in touch with everyone on Facebook, you know. This is from Rich in Washington, D.C.
Yeah.
What the hell is going on with all my stuff tonight? Look, my tie's going slanty on the table. My collar's popping out. It's all the boiled sweets. Rich in Washington, D.C. says, Dear Craig, my girlfriend says she doesn't want me playing fantasy baseball this year because it takes up too much of my time. What should I do? Get rid of her.
CBS cares.
Yeah, don't let her stand in the way of your fantasy football. This is from Bob in Providence, Rhode Island, who says, Dear Craig, why do those extra 5 minutes you get when you hit the snooze button feel so much better than the hours of sleep you had before it? You know what? Take your act to the chuckle club, buddy.
CBS cares.
Hey, why do those 5 minutes after the snooze button feel so much better than the sleep that came before?
Why? This is from Liz in New York, New York, who says, hey, Craig, is it true that guys like girls who love sports? Yeah, whatever you need to tell yourself. All right, this is from Lauren in Cincinnati, Ohio, who says, hey, Craig, my hair is getting long and I feel like cutting it, but I'm afraid that I may come to regret it 2 weeks later. What do you think? Don't give a rat's ass. All right, this is from Tyler in Shreveport, Louisiana, who says, hi, Craig, when you read people's tweets on air, do you notify them ahead so they can make sure and watch it? Well, now you know. This is from Brian in Davenport in Iowa, who said, I'm trying to get through them all tonight. I'm in some kind of a quest. Craig, what's the best way to get Jeff to host the Oscars next year? Convince him or the Oscars? No, two different things. One, Jeff is way too animated to host the current style of Oscar presentation. And two, he doesn't work Sundays. He's kind of like, it's like Chariots of Fire. Remember when they were trying to get the Scottish runner, Eric Liddell, to run in the champion, you know, to win the Olympics, but he wouldn't run on a Sunday. And everyone was like, what are you saying? It's the Olympics. They were French. What are you saying? Well, they weren't French. The Olympics were being held in, I think, France at the time. And they were like, you have to run on a Sunday. You have to run to win the Olympics. And Eric Liddell would say, I don't run on Sundays because I go to church. And the French were like, what? I mean, I'm paraphrasing a bit. The movie was a little better than that. But this is from Kristen in Raleigh in North Carolina, who says, Dear Craig, my friend says when a man offers to buy a woman a drink, he wants sex. Is this true? No, he's just concerned you're thirsty. There's nothing a heterosexual man hates more than seeing a thirsty, attractive woman. Well, look, I've got no designs on getting into your panties here. I just wondered if you could, you know, take a drink in order to loosen you up. First guest tonight is a very beautiful actress. She's in a new film called Electra Lux, which has got two X's in it, but I don't think it's a porn. Although I don't know. Who's to say? Me. Anyway, it's in theaters March the 11th. Take a look at this.
Life is fleeting, and if today is the day you want to be bad, why not be real bad?
And don't take this the wrong way. You're a very forward woman.
Forward and backward, too, if you catch my drift.
Just don't waste any time, do you?
I know what I like. And when I like it right away. So we can keep talking here and you can always wonder what if, or you can pull me inside and do to me everything you ever wanted to do with a woman in bed.
Can I buy you a drink?
Please welcome Carlo Gugino, everybody. Carlo Gugino.
I did bring you boiled sweets.
Yeah,
and,
no,
and
no,
it
you
was
did
really
not.
Unfortunate that was my choice.
No, no. You mean hard candy?
Well, that's a whole nother thing.
Hey, that blonde hair.
Blonde hair.
I'm glad to see you're you, though. I mean, it looked nice and everything, but
yeah,
you know.
But well, you know, you always look better with your natural color hair, sadly. But it's true. Most people.
Is that true?
I think so.
Well, then I better go to my natural color.
Exactly. I mean, like bright red.
Natural color. Do you know what I thought when I saw Christian Bale get his Oscar?
With his
I thought
red beard.
Somebody's advertising what's down below. Don't you think? I was thinking
the thought did not cross my mind, but
yes,
you're absolutely
see, of
right.
Course. You yeah, you go, oh, right. He's yes. Ginger down below me, boys. Yeah.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah, it's, yeah. I think everybody thought that when he was getting. I was like, oh, we know
only
now.
Only you.
Yeah.
Only you thought that.
Not me. You said
yes.
You.
No,
did you?
No,
did you
I said I didn't think
oh,
that,
didn't
but
think
I
that.
Think you're right.
What, can I buy you a drink?
But what's really funny is that Electrolux is a porn star.
Really?
My
the movie
character
is, a,
is
it a porn
actually
movie,
a porn
then?
Star. It is not a porn movie.
Okay.
sorry to disappoint. You don't see that much of her work. You see a little bit of her work.
All right.
But generally, you see
by
her.
By work, do you mean?
I mean, you know,
is there lesbians?
There are some lesbians in the movie, so you
love
also,
it.
Yeah. You will love it.
Yeah, no, yeah, everybody. lesbians are very fashionable right now with, you know, Black Swan.
Yes, it's true. It's yeah, true. But yeah. But haven't they always been kind of? It's
with
just
me, you yeah. Bet they have. Yeah. Yeah. Now, what happens then? You playing a porn star? In a movie?
I play a porn star. She is pregnant, which is tricky as a porn
oh,
star. She decides to quit, and she goes through all the things that women go through. It's like, can I be a good example? All of those things. Meanwhile, she is a porn star. Her name is Electrolux.
Yeah, but that's not a real name, right?
Well, she can't reveal those things. Do you know how to do your porn name?
No,
have you ever
I can't
done it?
Remember. How is it?
It's your first pet.
Right.
And the first street you lived on.
Right, okay, so I would, well, what's yours?
Mine is Rubby, Rubby Crespo.
Yeah.
I'm not sure that's so sexy, but,
yeah, no,
you know.
Oh, yeah, a little bit of Rubby
but
Crespo.
But Rubby Crespo could have some fun.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah.
No, I think mine would be, Olga Daruch.
Oh my God! You
sounds like a Lithuanian shot putter or something.
I was gonna say you're like in a, you're like Bergman gone porn.
Yeah, yeah,
you know?
It's, yeah. Olga. Yeah, I had a guinea pig called Olga when I was a kid. Well, it wasn't
you
really mine; it was my sister's. But you know, I got to hold it.
I feel like you have such a love for animals. Like,
I
did
do
you want to have a zoo? Like, I feel
I'd
like
I'd love to have a zoo.
I'm
do you
want to
open a zoo together?
I mean, maybe we could.
That's a great idea.
Wouldn't that be awesome?
That's maybe the best idea anybody's ever had. So
I'm just saying, let's think about it.
Carla Craig Zoo. Mm-hmm. That's the up to
yeah.
You first.
No, but I think
people would want that.
Craig and Carla. Yeah, yeah. I don't know. Maybe
what kind of
know.
Animals would you have in your zoo then?
Snooky.
Well, perhaps one could be called Snooky.
Yeah, yeah. I think we should have a kangaroo called Snooky and another
yeah,
one called The
say,
Situation.
We need a giraffe.
A giraffe.
That
oh,
could
I
be called The
giraffes.
Situation.
Although I have to say that I think giraffes sometimes can look a little bit, what's the word, pleased with themselves, a little smug. Do you know what I mean?
Because they're, yes, they are. Well, they're like, above everybody. They're looking down on everyone.
Yeah, and then it's like, you know, they can eat the salad from
they're
the top.
They're a little stuffy, those giraffes.
Do you think giraffes are stuffy?
Perhaps a little bit. Now, speaking of animals, I was born the year of the pig.
Oh, and
so I feel it's very appropriate
yes,
that today.
It is.
Yeah.
When's the year of the pig? Well, I'm not trying to work out how old you are.
Clearly.
Yeah.
Really? Must we reveal this
24?
Now?
24?
Exactly. And the picture of the pig that you showed is Danny DeVito,
yes.
Who, crazily enough, on March 11th also, I did this movie called Girl Walks Into a Bar. Two movies, same day, being released, crazy.
Wait.
And Danny DeVito is in Girl Walks Into a Bar.
No, wait. First of all, let me just stress that I didn't say Danny DeVito was a pig.
You showed him as that particular animal
no,
in that instance.
No,
I
said George
Danny.
Clooney's little cuddly friend. and then it was a picture of Danny DeVito. It was,
you did say, let's see the picture of the sweet pig or
no,
something
like
that.
No, I didn't say pig. I was very careful because...
And now I'm bringing it up, and we're reiterating.
Yeah, you're really getting me.
I'm really helping you here. Yeah.
See, I didn't want to mention that.
Danny will find it hilarious.
Well, Danny will be fine with it. Yeah. What I'm worried about is that I'll genuinely upset George Clooney all over again, and I never wanted to do that. I genuinely regret telling that joke. Do you ever say it and you regret sometimes?
I mean, every day, though.
Well, yeah, but I do it on the show.
But see, that's the thing, is you do it on the air.
And then it looks like I'm somehow uncaring about the man's, you know, pig. I feel
that he's probably gotten over it.
You know, I do. Usually George Clooney's sitting in an apartment in West Hollywood going, "That bitch!
Damn that Clooney!"
No, he's probably not. You're right. He's probably going, "I don't care about this. He doesn't know about this. He's in Italy."
Now he will.
Yeah, no,
he'll
he
know.
Won't.
He'll
no,
see
he
your apology.
No, he'll be all right. Yeah.
But yes. Two movies same day, which is crazy. And
well, does that mean you have to go on? Do you have to come back here tomorrow then?
I'm ready. We can talk more about our zoo.
Yeah, no, that'd be nice actually. You know, I do. Why do you want to open a zoo?
I never did until I just decided. Well,
right,
because
there?
You have so many animals, you have such love for animals. I thought you should open a zoo, but then you said let's do it together.
Oh well, I can do it my own if you want. I don't need you.
Oh, but you do.
I'd buy you a drink, but I don't need. No.
Speaking of drinks, Girl Walks Into a Bar is in L.A., one night, 10 bars in Los Angeles.
Is that a documentary? Did you actually do it?
Well, this is the thing. You shoot at the bars during the day. So you start at like 6 a.m. because the bars close, you know, they open at 6 p.m. So you need to be done shooting by then.
Right.
So about 1 p.m. you're like, I don't know, that martini's looking pretty good. Yeah. Like, I've been here for 6 hours. What am I doing in a bar if I'm not drinking? And I just, you know, I didn't, by the way.
Right.
I don't drink
while I'm working.
I don't
judge you for that. You know,
no,
I mean,
but
I had a hopeless alcohol problem years and years ago.
I'm
1 o'clock in the afternoon, like, home time. Yeah.
Yes.
So you never drank in the morning or compulsively?
No. Chocolate cake, now that's another thing.
Really?
Yeah,
but it's not the same thing. I mean, you won't have, you know, half a dozen chocolate cakes and then sleep with your friend.
It's
like...
a little chunky.
Yeah, you kind of go,
but happy.
Yeah. Really? Are you big on the chocolate?
I am big on the chocolate.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you, like, when you start eating it, you can't stop?
No, I can stop. I just don't ever go a day without chocolate.
No, neither do I.
Yeah, no,
same with my teeth hurt. I haven't had any today.
I know. Why do your teeth hurt?
Well, I had them cleaned.
Yeah, you know, and they get into the gums with
Well, yeah, and when you have Scottish teeth... I mean, I've only got about 3 or 4 Scottish ones left, but they're still...
but they're You're still. Becoming all American.
Oh, man.
You really are.
One tooth at a time, I tell you.
I like the disheveled look.
Yeah, it's
what happened before you came out here?
Well, you know, I kept trying to look like a late night talk show host, and then I thought, well, look, nobody else is trying. Why the hell do I? So I make a vague nod in that direction.
I really like it.
Oh, well, thank you. Yeah, I like the way you look.
Thank you.
Let's get started on that zoo. All right, we got to go. Well, you'll have to come back for the other movie.
Yes.
Would you like an awkward pause or a mouth organ?
I think I'm going to have to go with a mouth organ because...
I was really hoping you'd say...
I really, I don't know how to turn that down.
No, you shouldn't turn it down. It's fresh. It hasn't been touched.
I'm sadly not as good as you at this, but let's see what we can do.
I'm not very good at this. I actually can't play because my teeth hurt. I have to just kind of breathe on the organ.
Okay, here goes. I'm following you.
Oh, really? Like, then.
What do we do?
Suck and blow.
Well, that I can do. Here goes. I can't do
this
now.
Nice to see you. I haven't seen you in a while. It's nice to see you. National Pig Day Show. In the future, when men gather around campfires enjoying bacon sandwiches, they'll say to themselves, My next guest is in a movie. I think it's a movie. It's called Cedar Rapids, right? It's a movie, yeah. It's in theaters now. You should go and see it because he's in it. And his name, Tom Lennon, everybody. Tom Lennon. Lennon. Oh, knock it off. I'm just trying to, you know, there's we're so many all, things to avoid talking all... about. I thought I would talk about pig day, and now you come out and judge me.
I do an amazing, let's see this, watch this. That was nothing, I was nothing. Ready for my
right,
pig?
Right. No,
wait, do not do that. That is demeaning to pigs on pig day, and...
You don't look like a pig, you look like,
That was amazing. That's like a Pixar movie in a chair.
I like that. If a pig came out here, I'd talk to them.
I'd have to. It's my job.
No, you know what that's like? That was like the character Miggs in Silence of the Lambs.
Oh, my goodness, yes. Miggs is the guy in the next cell over. I didn't say the other part of it.
Right, yeah.
He's just the next cell over, and he asks Jodie Foster, says something very specific about Jodie Foster.
Yeah, he does. Do you like that movie?
Silence of the Lambs?
Yeah.
I love that movie.
Yeah, it's a good
Who
movie.
Doesn't
it's
love that
a
movie?
Scary movie.
Oh, Clarice.
Yeah.
Do you hear the lambs screaming, Clarice, as your daddy with the fondlings and the cars?
Did you see it?
This interview is not my demo reel.
No.
Between Piggy Guy and very average Anthony Hopkins.
I gotta say, I thought it was awful. I thought it was an awful Andy Hopkins.
You hear the pigs on pig day?
No, that sounds like a... That's R2-D2 Anthony Hopkins. That's...
Clarice.
What's the movie about then, Cedar Rapids?
Cedar Rapids is a terrific picture. It stars Ed Helms, your buddy. You like Ed Helms, right?
Sure.
Wow. Oh, my God. Wow. I went down the wrong, barking up the wrong tree.
Well, you know, Helms knows why.
Starring that.
Ooh, la, la. No. He knows why.
He knows why.
He knows why.
Well, is there some sort of banjo feud going on between you and him?
I don't know Ed Helms. I just said no. What?
No, I know. You aggressively were not going to meet, apparently.
No, come on. Don't start causing a celebrity feud between.
Oh, tweet feud. Twitter feud. Do you want to have a Twitter feud with me ever?
Yeah, all right. I had one with Stan Lee, though, and it got kind of...
Stan Lee's 90 going. Years old.
Yeah, he kept going, though.
He's a 90-year-old man.
He wore me down. I had to block
where
him.
Where on earth do you... You're yelling at a 90-year-old man on Twitter.
Hey!
We let you into this country.
Hey!
We invited you in. And you're yelling at our nanogenarians?
Hey,
what do we call them? Nanobots?
Whoa. First of all, I did not yell at him. He yelled at me.
What did he say specifically?
I can't remember. And I don't listen to people when they yell at me. I just cave in. I can't take it. It overwhelms me.
Especially Stan Lee.
Well, did Stan Lee ever yell at you?
Not yet.
Yeah, you're jealous.
Yeah. What did he invent? Every superhero?
Every single one.
Pretty
Batman,
much.
Superman, Eggman.
Batman.
Trouser Man.
Eggman.
Yeah.
Treasure Man.
No. Trouser Man. Yeah.
Trouser Man.
Yeah, he was very popular.
You gotta be careful, kids. You can meet Trouser Man when you least expect. They do PSAs. He's got a van and he comes by. Trouser Man. It's something to be aware of.
No, knock it off. You're scaring me. Yeah. So what's your movie about then?
Cedar Rapids is a great picture. It's about Ed Helms plays a character.
Well, what do you do? Never mind Helms.
I play a really, really sinister. I'm sort of one of the villains, actually.
You're a bad guy in a movie?
I know. Isn't that amazing? Because I'm so incredibly charming. You've seen me be a pig.
Yeah.
You've seen me do terrible Anthony Hopkins.
Yeah, right. Yeah, very, very bad.
And yet, I'm versatile enough to also be someone you don't like.
I find that hard to believe.
Yeah,
you know, everybody loves you. You're kind of like Raymond.
For a second, I thought you said like Rain Man.
Yeah, I was going to say that.
Which feels also pretty accurate,
too.
You
do actually go to Vegas a lot, though, don't you? And count cards and cheat and stuff.
Oh, I used to. Oh, God, I used to. And then a baby. And then that just...
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, you've...
They frown on... When you have a baby at a blackjack table, they just frown.
I got a new one.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
That's exciting.
Like a month old.
Oh, it's the best.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. It's the best.
Yeah, no, it's...
Having a baby.
It's all right.
It's the best.
Well...
Great. Fills your heart with joy. No, it really does.
It sounds a bit like me and Ed Helms there, right? What's the name of your baby? Ed Helms? What did you have, a boy or a girl?
I have a boy. My son Oliver is 20 months old.
Oh, well, that's awesome. 20 months is good. That's
fantastic.
When do you stop doing months and go to years? Is that a thing with your people?
Two, right?
Yeah, I don't know.
With my people? What was that?
Well, you know.
That was the subtlest kind of racism, because... Yeah, you know, I feel like you, I look kind of like you. Your people.
Yeah, well, that's what I meant.
The people down in steerage on the Titanic. Those people.
Oh, there's no possible way this could sink.
Leprechauns, my people.
No,
my boy is 20 months old. And is this, here's, do you find this true? I went from a person, I didn't cry for like 10, 15, 20 years.
You're right.
Now I cry 3 to 9 times a day.
Wow.
I just cry all day long.
What? The sleep deprivation?
Probably partially.
Yeah.
And partially just seeing him, like, just my irony's dead. My thinking everything stupid meter's broken.
Ah, yeah.
So now if he looks at anything, just like, you know, like a billboard for lap bands, and he goes, wow.
Are you telling me?
I start crying.
Are you telling me that this child has melted your cold comic
my
heart?
My cold, cold leprechaun heart it has.
You phony bastard.
And his name is escapes me for the moment.
No. I think it's touching. It is
touching.
It is. They do that. Yeah. I've got an older boy as well, who's just at the point now where everything I say is stupid.
The worst.
Yeah.
Teenage boys are the worst.
No, he's not a teenager. He's only 9.
Oh, the worst. 9-year-old boys are the worst.
Wait a minute.
They're the worst.
You're Ed Helmsing me, aren't you?
I like your TARDIS, by the way.
Oh, thanks very much.
Not to be a nerd, but it's a nice looking TARDIS you got going on.
No, it's not a real one.
There is no. Not to get weird, but not a real TARDIS. A real TARDIS is a fictional thing anyway.
So you're telling me that Doctor Who, the cult series on the BBC, is fiction?
I wouldn't do that here.
You'd be right not to.
I don't want to answer to your Twitter followers, who are a lively bunch, no doubt.
Are they?
Yeah,
no, how many of you have got in the Twitter now?
73,000.
I follow you.
Track.
I follow you in the Twitter.
Thank you.
Yeah. No, I did. You're hilarious.
I know.
But see that thing you do at the end of, every night.
Every night, I say something very scary.
Yeah, something
you
very
don't like
creepy.
That.
Yeah. Well,
yeah.
I, you know.
Yeah. I say things like every night on Twitter, I put my Twitter followers to sleep, and I say, sleep tight. Remember, very few things can eat a large adult human being, except another stealthy adult human being. Just like little thoughts to get inside your head.
Yeah,
you know?
I know. It doesn't help me get to sleep reading your nighttime tweets, but I feel that if I block you, then it would be seen as an act of aggression.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, I'll go Stan Lee all over your ass.
Yeah.
And I'm half his age, which means the energy level will be very high.
Yeah, no, that's good. But he's Stan Lee, though. He has powers that you
and
I don't
possess. Trouser Man.
Yeah, Trouser Man.
Who's Trouser Man's enemy?
Yeah.
The Belt Witch. The dreaded Belt Witch.
I'd say To Catch a Predator is Trouser Man's enemy.
Just Dateline, yeah.
Mouth organ, awkward pause.
Mouth organ.
All right.
Wow, this is a long one.
Heard that?
No. It is a slightly long, come on.
Yeah, it is a slightly longer, no, can you play? Oh, it'd be so awesome if you could play, because hardly anybody can play. No, you can't. You can do that with your hand doesn't mean you can play.
That looks like playing.
No, it doesn't.
Brown Star Insurance has been awarded the prestigious Two Diamond Award from the American Society of Mutual Insurers for 3 years running. Because at Brown Star Insurance, we insure your dreams.
Holy Christmas, you're knocking around with Steve Dean's heart, buddy.
I'm just a pretty face. That copy was all you, Bill.
Well, I do have one gripe with you, boss.
Mm-hmm.
If you'd waited till after Cedar Rapids, I could have won the two diamonds for you 4 years running.
4 years.
How do you do it, Ryan?
If you're watching Craig at home, you're missing half the fun. Consider this your formal invitation to laugh live in our studio audience at a taping of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson. Please give us a call at 323-570-0059 or visit our website at oneiota.com.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Craig?
Say to me, are you drunk? And I'm like, no, I'm not drunk, you idiot. I'm a rabbit. I do like to spend a lot of time with my friend Jeffrey Peterson, who's a skeleton robot. But a lot of people say you shouldn't hang out with skeleton robots because it'll make you evil. And I think that's